Hey, guys. Welcome back to the Tenorshare AI's channel. After OpenAI and Google, Microsoft finally joins the AI war.
We have a computer for people who love Windows that they can be very, very proud of.
On the first day of Microsoft Build 2024, Microsoft introduced the world to a new category of Windows PCs designed for AI, Copilot Plus PCs, which goal is to beat Apple's MacBooks.
Apple's done a fantastic job of really innovating on on the Mac. We are going to outperform them.
In today's video, we're diving deep into the AI capabilities of the new Microsoft AI PC and the MacBook Pro 2024. Let's get started. First, let's look at the hardware. Microsoft Surface Pro 11 is part of the new wave of Copilot Plus PCs and supports all the AI features that Microsoft is introducing in Windows 11. This machine is equipped with a dedicated AI chips. This AI chips is designed to handle AI-specific tasks, offloading work from the CPU and GPU, which can significantly speed up processing times for AI-driven applications. On the other hand, the MacBook Pro 2024 is powered by Apple's M3 Max chip. While it doesn't have a separate AI co-processor, the M3 Max have an enhanced neural engine to accelerate powerful machine learning models, which accelerates AI computations across the entire system. Microsoft says the new Surfaces are 58% faster than the MacBook Air with M3 and has 20% longer battery life.
We finally feel we have a very competitive product between Surface Pro and the Surface laptops. We have essentially the best specs.
Then, let's talk software. The first amazing feature is the recall. It might happen to you that you can't find something we know we have seen before on our PC. Now with recall, you can scroll across time to find the content you need in your timeline across any application, website, document, or more by simply using the cues you remember. The second thing is Co-Create with AI-powered image creation and editing built into Windows. Image Creator in Microsoft Designer is an AI image generator. Yet, today's cloud offerings may limit the number of images you can create, keep you waiting while the artwork processes, or even present privacy concerns. Now, on Copilot Plus PCs, you can generate endless images for free, fast, with the ability to fine-tune images to your liking and to save your favorites to collections.
How do we really take good old paint and say, hey, I'm not just painting myself, but I'm able to co-create with an AI?
And that's not all. Microsoft also announced Adobe's flagship apps are coming to Copilot Plus PCs, including Photoshop, Lightroom, and Express. Also amazing software like DaVinci Resolve Studio, CapCut, Liquid Text, and more.
And select Auto Cutout. Now notice what would typically be running my CPU and GPU is now almost entirely handled by the NPU at 67% utilization. And just like that, AI has masked and detected all five dancers throughout the entirety of this minute-long clip.
Apple has done the same thing. Apple's AI integration shines in apps like Final Cut Pro and Logic Pro, where machine learning models assist with video editing, audio enhancements, and even generating creative suggestions. The biggest update to the appearance of the Microsoft PC this time is undoubtedly the Copilot key. Every Copilot Plus PC comes with a personal, powerful AI agent with the new Copilot key. Just a single tap, we can get access to the latest models, including OpenAI's GPT-4o, which is really powerful.
It's kind of like a new browser, effectively. So it's right there, it sees the screen, it sees the world, it hears you. And so it's kind of like that personal agent that's always there that you want to talk to, you can interrupt it, it can interrupt you.
Apple is also making Siri a more powerful AI assistant. Apple is trying to work with OpenAI to introduce generative AI features. Hope to see more exciting news at the upcoming WWDC on June 10. I think the biggest highlight in the new Microsoft AI PC is actually live captions. Live captions can translate any live or pre-recorded audio in any app or video platform from over 40 languages into English subtitles instantly, automatically, and even while you're offline, which can really bring people all over the world closer together. What do you guys think? Which AI features do you find more appealing? And which device would you choose? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. That's all for today. Don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time.